हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ मिसेस दीपाली येवले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ENTC डिपार्टमेंट, AISSMS, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. माय टुडेज सेशन इज ऑन हैंड्स ऑन माइक्रोविन सॉफ्टवेयर. ओपन माइक्रोविन सॉफ्टवेयर. नाउ वी विल गो फॉर डिज़ाइन ऑफ सीमॉस नैंड एंड नॉर गेट विथ एंड विदाउट कैपेसिटिव लोड using Microwin software. First we will go for CMOS NAND gate, where two PMOS are to be connected in parallel and two NMOS are to be connected in series. So first we will select PMOS. For PMOS, adjust the width and length, generate device. Again you can go for copy and paste. You can make copy of this PMOS. So now we have two PMOS. Now we will require NMOS. Adjust length and width of the NMOS. Generate device. Copy NMOS. Make copy of this NMOS. I want to move this NMOS below first NMOS because I want two series connection of NMOS. So now we have two PMOS and two NMOS. Now we will go for connection part. I will just stretch and move these to NMOS. Here. Okay. Now use metal one to connect drain off. Just I will zoom this so that I will be able to NMOS part. Now use metal one and connect drain of one PMOS to the drain of second PMOS. Now connect source of one PMOS to the source of another PMOS. Also do the connection for NMOS part also using metal one. I need to move this second NMOS also use metal one for connecting the series NMOS to the parallel PMOS. Okay, this is not done. Just I will erase this part. I have to select gun. Okay. I can use gun if I have done some wrong connection. So use this gun to remove this wrong connection. Okay. Now next part is nothing but providing inputs and observing output. So
VDD should be given to well, VDD to NWell, as well as VDD should be given to drain. Then the SS part, it should be given to NMOS. And now other inputs are nothing but A and B. So A, I have to give A here. Now adjust the length and low and high time. So this is nothing but my A. Adjust low and high time of our A signal. A. Now B signal. I have to give B signal here. Second input B. Again, A and B should be given to the N MOSFETs. So, this is again A. Recall the low and high time of our A signal. So, it is 0.500, 0.500. But I don't want that to be visible in simulation. So, not in simulation, assign. Now, B. B input, not visible in simulation, assign. Now I want to observe the output. So here output, label name is output, visible in simulation, assign. Now go for run simulation. Now this is the output of the CMOS NAND gate. According to the truth table of the CMOS NAND gate, when both the inputs are 0, see, when A and B are 0, the output should be 1. When one input is 1, another is 0, output is 1. When both inputs are 1, 1, then output is 0. Okay, so this is nothing but output of the CMOS NAND gate without capacitive load. Now I will just add the capacitive load. Again, I will show you the simulation. Now see the rise and fall time again. Range of rise and fall time. Now I will, using the palette, I can add capacitor at the output. So capacitor of value 0.01 picofarad I am adding at the output, and after simulation I have observed increase in rise and fall time. So this is nothing but design of CMOS NAND gate using Microwin software with and without capacitive load. Now I will go for CMOS NAND gate. CMOS NOR gate we will go for. For CMOS NOR gate I will be requiring 2 PMOS in series and 2 NMOS in parallel. Okay, so now I will create new project here. So I will just create one project new. So PMOS, as usual, adjust the length and width of your NMOS. Generate device, just copy this. Okay, so I have 2 PMOS in series. Now 2 NMOS. We will use 2 NMOS. This is 1 NMOS. Copy it. This is 2nd NMOS. I will just stretch it, move it at the upper side. Okay, now the connection part. So metal one to connect one PMOS to another PMOS. I just need to stretch this PMOS. Okay. I will use metal okay now next I have to get again this metal out connect this I am selecting gun to remove unwanted connection. Now using metal 1. I want to connect this here. Again also I want now connect source together, source of 2 NMOS together. Remove unwanted part, if any. Now gate, this gate should be connected to this gate, but instead of that we will provide the input now. Now the part remaining is nothing but our input. Okay, so we will provide the input. First of all VDD to the NVL, VDD to second NVL, then VDD to drain. Now VSS to ground. Now A and B inputs. A input given here. A point. Okay, 0.500, same whatever I have prepared it initially, I will keep the same values. A, then second input is B, second input is B, 0.750. 0.750%. Then same input should be provided to the NMOS transistors. A 0.500, but not visible in simulation, assign. Then B input. Point 0.750, you can keep as per your requirement, not visible simulation, assign. Now observe the output. So label output, assign. Now run your simulation. Now here for CMOS NOR gate, when both the inputs are 0, See here, both the inputs are 0, then output should be both the input A and B are 0. Where, see here, both the inputs are 0, output is 1. When any of the input is 0, here B input is 0, here A input is 0, your output will be 0. Also, if both the inputs are 1, see here, both the inputs are 1, output is 0. Now see the rise and fall time range. It's 8 picosecond rise time and 7 picosecond fall time. Now we will add the capacitor and we'll observe the effect of that capacitive load. So add the capacitor at the output. Okay. And after simulation, you will get the same output, but observe increase in rise and fall time. So this is nothing but the simulation of the CMOS NOR gate with and without capacitive load using Microwin software.